reason that I chose to do this is that I've been inspired by being a dual language teacher for the past 6 years. I remember it being brought to my attention that soon the program was going to be entering my grade, and when I was told about the program, there was no hesitation in me wanting to be a part of this because I saw the impact that this had had so far already on the students since pre-kindergarten. I was going to take on the journey of being a dual language teacher. Something that I've learned in the dual language program is that working in a collaborative teaching model really brings out more than you could ever imagine in yourself as an educator. I was fortunate enough to be with a teacher who taught the Spanish side of our program, who really saw eye to eye with me and was able to not only develop her own teaching practices, but also develop mine as well. That is probably one of the biggest parts of this program and the most impactful part for me. My partner teacher and I both took on the opportunity to complete the National Board certification process. We have taught seamlessly together for the past 6 years. We plan together, talk about our students, collaborate, have parent-teacher conferences together. After being a part of this program, our current students are now in 10th grade, and the reason that I wanted to do this video is because the dual language program has become something that is not only special to me, but also something that I think is very special about the Ossining School District. So what you're going to see is me getting the lucky opportunity to interview and speak to some of my past students who are now all the way up as far as 10th grade, and also get a chance to meet some of the students that I will be meeting hopefully in the next few years. You'll also see other teachers that are in the program and hear from administrators, hear from students most importantly, and community members.
We have over 700 kids. We've been here since 2003. Mm-hmm. If right now people don't realize that this is the reality of our school district, that half of the kids in this district are Hispanic.
So we looked at some of the research, which also helped us create the dual language program. And we noticed that everything that we've rested the prominence and dominance in the student's native language accelerates the acquisition of a second language. Therefore, if we really build a foundation in their language and they become wonderful readers and writers in Spanish, for example, that actually accelerates English development. We believe that the use of the native language allows access and immediate comprehension of academic subject areas. So for example, in a dual language classroom, students are able to understand mathematics, science, and social studies because it's provided in their native language. While in the ESL classes only, students are not afforded that opportunity. So they're trying to learn math and science and social studies in a language that they really don't understand as of yet. And then, one of the most important things is that the use of the native language lowers the effective filter. And basically that means that if you understand what's going on, then you're happily in learning and you're happily in that environment and you understand everything the teacher is saying. While if you're in a situation where you have anxiety or you don't understand what's going on, you might be so in shock that you can't hear and comprehend anything. If you look in the dual language program, we had more kids at level 3 than we did in ESL. And for me, that means that students are meeting proficiency. People think that if students are in Spanish, that actually regresses their English development, but notice that in dual language, we actually had kids in English, in an English test, meet at that percentage, 7%. It's not the same thing for mathematics. Here we're very proud that in the actual, after the cut scores, the students in dual language still maintain that level 3. So this data actually proves to us that creating a transitional bilingual program would not regress their progression in English. It actually increases that acceleration of English.
The use of language is one of the tasks of the preschool child. Dual language programs at the preschool level are organized to build on the child's first language and introduce a second language as part of the school experience. Children learn, grow, and emerge as bilingual individuals. In a global context, there are genuine advantages to being bilingual. The preschool child must also develop social competence. He or she must learn to share and to express preferences in order to manage friendships. Roosevelt School in Ossining, New York offers a dual language program for preschool children. Using a 50-50 English-Spanish model, the school educates 63-year-olds and 72 four-year-olds, preparing them to be bilingual and biliterate.
And in hearing you call our children bilingual, that's put a different thought in my mind as well, because I had not thought of my four-year-old as being bilingual. Mm.
For me, it all started when my oldest was 3 years old and there was a First Steps program. After that experience, I knew that this was something that it was important for him to be exposed to culture that's predominant in our neighborhood. So we thought it would be important, if we were going to be a part of this community, to have our kids learn how to speak Spanish. And what an opportunity, a hidden gem in this Ossining School District, to have this program.
It's our tradition from our countries, because if they need to visit the family in Ecuador, they need to know how to speak Spanish. It's very important. It's our first language. But since we're in this country, they need to know both. I think the opportunity to have a bilingual education gives them the possibility to interact with more people, to be integrated with everyone, to communicate with their families. This is a country with people from so many cultures, and it helps them to learn about each of them. I think it's a real advantage to speak two languages. I have an 11-year-old son who speaks Spanish and English well. He tells me, "Mom, I'm worth two people because I know how to speak Spanish and I know how to speak English." I have a little one in First Steps, and my older one helps the younger one. I feel proud when he tells me, "Mom, I am Latino."
What about the kids in this class? What do they speak?
Spanish and English.
Yeah?
Hola.
Hola. What is hola? What is that word in English? What does it mean?
Hi.
It means hi. What do you think about speaking two languages?
Dejen de sonar la libertad desde las rocas cubiertas de nieve de Colorado. Dejen de sonar la libertad desde las curvosas cuestas de California, pero no solo eso. Dejen de sonar la libertad de la montaña de piedra de Georgia. Dejen de sonar la libertad desde la montaña local de Tennessee. Dejen de sonar la libertad desde cada valle y montaña de Mississippi. De cada lado de montaña, dejen de sonar la libertad.
¿Tu mariposa? Si sigue las instrucciones, mira cómo va a quedar tu jirafa. ¡Wow!
16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
¡Oh, fabuloso! A ver, la próxima, de 21 a 30. Eso, tu turno.
Yo tengo.
¿Qué tienes? Yo tengo ocho.
Ossining High School is not the only school among our 2,800 plus international and domestic school members to receive these awards. It is the only school to date to have successfully earned three Program of Distinction. In today's interconnected world, there's clear need for students in all countries to develop the ability to view the world from the perspective of others, as well as to gain communication skills in more than one language. Proficiency in other languages and cultural agility are essential 21st century skills for successfully interacting with others socially, politically, and to be successful in the workplace. The World Language Program of Distinction acknowledges the school system's commitment to a proficiency-based, culturally grounded sequence of language of one of more languages, including the heritage language of the school community. Tangible evidence of this commitment is an instructional program that dedicates the necessary time and intensity conducive to cultivating intermediate and advanced communication proficiency in other languages. The world language faculty here at Ossining has demonstrated that its dedication to language education through a well-articulated, learner-appropriate program.
I think the dual language program has been great for me, and I think it's affected my life in a lot of ways, in the sense that I've been able to get really close with the people that I've been with, for example, like my peers that I've known since pre-K. I think it's important because I've learned a lot from dual language, how to speak better in Spanish and how to have better conversation with native speakers. And I could also relate to native speakers as well. I think my Spanish is a lot better now because I feel like I have a better perspective on what Spanish is as opposed to the way I used to be, because I'm a native speaker. So I usually just speak with whatever knowledge that I already have. But like when you get down to it, dual language has helped me learn like everything, like even grammar, pronunciation, things like that. Feels amazing. Yeah. Feels amazing because I know that I get, those are like the kind of opportunities that not everybody gets to have. And that's something I think about all the time, is that I get to have these college credits before other kids who work hard. You know, I'm a sophomore and there are kids, you know, seniors in my SUNY class who worked so hard to get there, and I'm already there. The way everything was set up, the way how it was, one day it was English, one day it was Spanish, I feel like that really helped. Like it's not, like it really, it made it a lot easier for us, like as kids, because it was, and it was more fun for us. I thought that it was just like something that I genuinely enjoyed, like one day speaking in Spanish, one day speaking in English, and then learning different things in each language, being able to get all of the knowledge that I can.
Growing up with the same group of kids was like really fun because you really get to know each other, and it's like they're your like second family. Even though like I speak Spanish at home, I learned so much at school. I learned how to speak more fluently. I love traveling, and it's like a bonus that I speak two languages.
My Spanish now is way better, and it's not just like speaking Spanish, it's like knowing grammar and knowing how to communicate with others. Mm-hmm. You know, students who you knew from like third grade or, you know, preschool and stuff. So like, you knew them. It doesn't matter if you haven't talked to them in ages, you could just talk about the dual language program. Oh, remember this and remember that.
That recently I just like helped translate for parents during back to school nights. And I mean, that helps you because you're doing community service and you feel good about yourself. Second grade, I remember when it was my first day, like when I just came back from Ecuador and I didn't know nobody. And like Natalie Pilaz, she was the one that helped me with everything. And now I'm just like, thank you. And I felt uncomfortable because I didn't know English. But like, yeah. I felt like people in there knew Spanish, so I spoke Spanish.
Whenever, like, I was in the English class and I wanted to say something, like, a bunch of people were trying to help me, like, they wanted to know Spanish, and they were, like, very welcoming, and it wasn't like I was just a stranger that didn't know English. Like, they were always like, oh, this is consist, and, like, I can help you with this, and, like, they were very nice. It was easier than just, like, being stuck in an English class with not having any Spanish. Most of the students spoke Spanish, so I felt very comfortable. Accomplished a lot in like my years, because like most of the students there are in 11th grade or 12th grade, and I'm like, I'm in 10th grade and I'm taking college little class. It feels really good.
I think that the dual language program is really good for young kids because they're immersed in the language. Like when kids start in 7th grade, they have to learn like the basics, and then the teachers start teaching them grammar. But the way it works in the dual language program is the basics are taught, and then the kids are immersed entirely in that language. Like they'll learn math and science and social studies in that language. So it's a lot easier for the kids to learn everything else in that language. You're also learning about Spanish culture, and you know, some of the kids in the dual language program are Spanish, but some aren't, and it gives them a really good outlook on things that otherwise they wouldn't know about. I'm good at, like, if I see a word that I don't understand, I can figure it out, like, really easily. And an eye for language, which the dual language program got for me.
I was in a book club this year, and I had to respond to other opinions and see both sides of arguments. This has changed my way of thinking towards reading.
I'm the only person who speaks to the family.
And so what was that like? That had to be really tough?
Well, it was. You know, I didn't really get to practice as much at home as some other people did. So it was somewhat hard for me to keep up with the language.
So how did you keep up?
I would try to teach my cousins and stuff, Spanish. Fácil para hablar en con ellos en español, más es como hablando con un stranger, una persona que no en conoces.
I like it because it's like being a family.
What languages do you speak?
English and Spanish.
Yeah, and do you have a sister in the program?
Yes.
What grade is your sister in?
Ninth.
Manzana.
Apple. Spaghetti.
That's the same word.
No, it's spaghetti because it has an E. Oh. Spaghetti has an S.
I help her to work at Spanish.
Now I can talk with most of the world because many people know Spanish.
When one of our friends was a new kid in the class, I was helping him understand things.
If you don't know more than one language, then how are you supposed to, like, if you want to travel around the world as a job, how are you supposed to know what other people are saying? Like, for example, if you're going to Africa, how are you going to know what they're saying if you don't know another language?
I learned how to speak Spanish first, so I needed to learn how to speak English. And then when I learned, if I didn't go to a dual language class, I'd forget all about Spanish.
That dual language is sort of like a big family because it's like they're helping each other along in the Spanish program and English. And like when somebody messes up, like they don't make fun of you.
You get to stay with the same friends you've had for many years. And it's really a relief that in case you can't communicate with other people, because they don't speak your language, you have another way to communicate with people. Because if they speak Spanish, don't speak English, and they know Spanish, and you speak Spanish, you could like talk with them.
Because there are two classes, and there's like a bunch of kids, just like you, and somebody else far away, which have like a lot of family over there. It makes it like a one big family. But in dual language, it's like two classes together, like a big family out of all the kids that are compared together.
¿Qué sabemos ya de los derechos? ¿Qué derechos? Abran su mente, piensen, escriban. Yo pienso que es un derecho. Es uno de los derechos, porque son importantes, ¿ok? Tienen que pensar.
Yo he aprendido a ser las llaves y derechos.
Sol achicharo la tierra de la granja hasta dejarla tan dura como la...
Podían tomar observaciones, pero yo me gusta hacer un tabla de información, y para esto yo creo que puedes organizarlo en los mililitros que de agua y también sodio de no agua que agregas al poliacrilato de sodio.
Let's hear some of the reasons why our students think they were selected as a student of distinction.
I think that I was selected because I asked questions, because there's a saying that a wise man can learn more from a fool's question than a fool can learn from a wise man's answer.
Yeah.
Wow. Roosevelt School, everybody. Roosevelt School.
I really try to do my best when I'm speaking Spanish in my class. I always try to say what I can, and if I don't know how to say it, I try to find another way to say it.
Ahora puede hablar en un lenguaje que muchas personas que saben desde inglés y puede comunicar más.
El programa de dos idiomas se ha impactado yo, es que yo ahora puedo hablar dos idiomas y puedo comunicarse con más mayor mayoría de personas y que una persona necesita ayuda que no le habla inglés, como puede hablar español a ellos y ayudarle.
Helps us learn more languages, and it helps us interact with people who don't speak English and make friends with people who don't speak English. You get to learn languages from a very young age, and instead of learning it like from the beginning, it's sort of harder to learn from when you're older. It's easier to learn when you're younger. I've traveled and spoke the same language as the people who live in Nicaragua when I went there in the third grade.
It's a really cool opportunity, and it's something that not everybody gets to do. It's just something that you should really cherish because you are one of the few people who get to experience life in two languages.
That you could communicate with more people that you couldn't around the world, and so it really helps. There is a lot of Latin people and Hispanic in this country now than there were, and so you have the advantage to speak with them, and so that's how it opens a lot more jobs for you than just speaking one language. And being trilingual is also a good way.
And a lot of the teachers we remember because they might have took us a little bit farther in the language. We're just like thankful that we have such good teachers in the program.
In one way, there's twice as much work for the English zone. Absolutely. Spanish zone, I think there's five times as much work for the teacher. But for the English zone, there's twice as much work in one way, in that you're working with twice the number of children. So the paperwork is doubled. The number of conferences is doubled. The number of assessments is doubled. But then there are things that are half the work, such as you have a partner you're working with, and I can teach one aspect of reading while my partner teaches another aspect of reading at the same time. Or we can double down. We both teach the same aspect and it's twice as effective. I am happy every day when I leave school.
We have to be advocates for ourselves. I understand why you can't hear this, because you're in a building with 17 other teachers and you're trying to keep up with them. And I've always said, do language has its own pace in Canada. Do language has its own report card issues. Do language has this, do language has that. If we are not advocating either through me or through each other, then we're always going to feel that we're never comparable to them. In your mind, you have to realize that together, you are meeting all those goals for the end of the year. So when I hear my people saying, well, I don't have enough time because I'm only with kids half the time, you are forgetting your partner. You are denying your partner's work. So we have to continue that same mentality for ourselves. So maybe we have a goal for our kids, but maybe we should have a goal for our teachers. What are our beliefs about dual language? Because if we're always thinking that we're behind or that we're not doing exactly the same things, then we are putting ourselves at a disadvantage, and then you're going to be frustrated and you're going to be disheartened, and then you're going to want to leave the program. And that's the last thing that I want.
Because I don't have a parent that speaks Spanish, so it was kind of difficult to do my homework every night and have to like use the internet as my resource. My mom took a Spanish class with my dad, and then they came home and they were helping me with my homework.
I do wish there were some more support for the parents of both sides in their native language. This is something that we would really like to beef up for parents outside of their children's education. How is it that we can support the parents to find the resources, what kind of books to read in their non-native language, what level, does the library have those books available? How does a parent help their child pick those books out? So homework questions is always an issue in my household, especially in the younger level years. How do we solve these problems when we need to translate them first? So more resources for parents.
I think that we're in a unique situation because of our design of our school district.
Mm-hmm.
So dual language looks different in each building mm-hmm. because we have different grade levels in each building. And I think what we need is to have our DL teachers together so that they learn the same strategies at the same pace and then readjust it to the grade level. If you look at dual language in another district that has K-5 schools, you'll see a lot more of that work being done together. So the practices are almost seamless.
Right? Right.
This is what we're doing in first grade, and this is how we build upon it until fifth grade. Here, it's a little bit different. It's like, all right, these are the best practices for all of the kids in the fifth grade here in this building.
Right.
And I think that makes us a little bit isolated. It's basically a school within a school, a dual language program. So we have to get those teachers trained together.
It's still demanded to be a dual language teacher. It's not any less so. But there's also that many of you have said sitting here today how much you love your partner. And when you have your own class, that's a very isolated situation. And when you have a partner teacher, now you're in it together. And when it's a great combo, it's a great combo. And it feels so wonderful because you really do feel like it's a partnership, not just between the children, but also between the adults. And so there are offsetting variables that can make it a very pleasurable way of teaching if we could take away some of the unnecessary freneticism. So I think curriculum work is really important to the success of dual language programs. You need it, however it's going to happen. And like I say, some districts do it by having a curriculum specialist who's supporting all the grades, who every day all they do is write and develop curriculum and bring it to you. And others do it by giving you summer paid weeks to develop curriculum that you will use for the following year. But you have Spanish standards, and those need to be written into the units, okay, because they exist. We're getting curriculum, and we're being told that, of course, we will implement the same curriculum as the rest of the school, and then we have to figure out how to do that. Because when you don't fix language to subject, you are increasing your coordination demands dramatically. And you are increasing your materials demands dramatically. Whatever choices you make, how am I going to align to the mainstream curriculum? And again, here's where you have a lot of problems, because if you're alternating everyday language, one person is very happy because they're doing it in English and the curriculum already exists. The other person is crying every night because they have to make all that subject matter in the other language. And they have to do it for every subject in every unit. That's exhausting. It's very hard to deliver a certain program, a certain phonics program, or a certain math program if it only exists in one language and not the other. So do both teachers have appropriate credentials for the program so that they can implement all of the regulations that are on you? Are both teachers very knowledgeable about dual language programs? Were they really well prepared to enter the dual language program? It's a very demanding program, and it has a lot of requirements to make sure that it's going to go well. I wouldn't do, if it was doing millipedes and sloths and sharks, and I don't feel that those fit culturally in context of Latin American culture, I might use other animals that are more common, like tree frogs. She was talking about Puerto Rico, right? Coqui and other animals. Like, why are you sticking me with sloths?
At parent-teacher conferences, I was pleasantly surprised by how many parents mentioned Jackie during their own children's conferences, as they were all very impressed by her ability to take the initiative to help others translate for those who cannot speak English out of the school setting.
We go hide away.